This is a dream come true for me, baby.
What are you girls up to?
You just have to have this on your wedding night. We can't wait.
Fredericks of Hollywood? What do my little sisters think I am?
Good Lord, look out!
Get off my sister!
On the ground.
Thank you.
How do I know who you are, Princess? How do I know you're the real April de Longpré? And who's this good-looking devil, April? He your husband?
Not yet. Two more weeks.
Choo-choo. What kind of name is that?
His real name's Chad. She just calls him Choo-choo.
May I have my wallet back, please?
You bet, April. Sure thing. Anything you say.
Hey, Choo Choo. I want to wish you the best.
I really did think that. Hope's a better word for it. That you were out here looking for me. Are you?
Couldn't sleep.
I know you've got a lot of things on your mind right now. With the wedding,
coming up. Everything. Yeah. I can understand that. So, I'll be saying goodnight. Goodnight.
Goodnight. I want you to get out of my house. Do you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to inconvenience you. It's just that I needed a nice hot shower.
It sure is nice smelling soap.
I'm warning you.
No wonder women smell so good. What is it? Essence of lilac?
I want you to leave this house immediately or I'm going to call the police.
No, ma'am. I don't think you will. Our chance meeting last night clued me into you. Is this Baxter drawing my hair to all the sense?
I don't care about your hair. Just get your dog and go.
How can I do that when it says right here on the bottle, wait 3 minutes after conditioning or your hair will be unmanageable?
If you got any ideas about going near that phone, I might just take it upon myself to walk out in the front lawn.
Naked.
Bare ass naked. You wouldn't want that, would you?
It's a beautiful day, isn't it? You had your chance, but you didn't run away, did you?
No, I didn't.
And you didn't call the police either?
No, I didn't.
Why not? Do you suppose?
Oh, I hope you don't mind, but I helped myself to a bottle of champagne. I usually try not to drink during the day, but this being a special occasion, I figured I'd do.
You frighten me.
I understand. I'm sorry I had to come into your house like this, but since I'm only going to be in town a day or so, that doesn't give us much time. And I knew you wouldn't mind. Let's go over there. Sit on the couch. And get to know one another.
You're the cockiest son of a bitch I've ever met in my life.
Not really. I just like to hear myself talk. And I like beautiful things. A woman like you comes along only once in a lifetime.
Bullshit.
I swear. of your perfume. As I'm driving from town to town, put a little on my hand. Right there. I'll bring it up to my nose, and every time I smell it, I'll remember you and how beautiful. Off of you. I was gonna come and just have a shower, a nice hot cup of coffee, but you excite me so much I can't help myself.
Nothing like this has ever happened to me before.
I went to a store in the Mojave out in California. The man there taught me how to use one of these. Thought for sure I was gonna buy one. Told me he shot a video of his wife playing with herself. Can you imagine that? A total stranger telling me something like that. TV. How about a little smile? Well, you don't feel like smiling. I can understand that. But April, darling, I didn't just show up here by mistake. You invited me. You might not know it, but you did. It's all right there in your eyes.
It's me, baby. I just spoke to the real estate agent in Tuscaloosa. The condo's ours. Congratulations. Look, I'm gonna stay up here a few more days, lock things down, make sure everything's perfect when we get here, okay? I love you, baby. Big kiss. Bye.
The lady's got a secret, don't you? I ain't got no secret. I ain't got nothing except a bike, a truck, a post office box in Clearwater, Florida.
I love the way that you Go to him. Ask him to take you for a ride on his bike. Nothing but the sound of the engine and the clouds in the sky. Don't worry about me. I'm taking a bus out of here in the morning. I don't know where I'm going, but I can't wait to get there.
Arrangement. You are beyond social redemption.
What's better than being hysterical?
You lose, mister. You're all alone. You don't care about anybody, and nobody gives a shit about you.
That's right, baby. I'm the Phantom of the Night.
Asshole.
Princess.
Motherfucker.
Sweet pea.
Cocksucker.
Greenbug.
Scumbag.
Precious.
Pig shit.
Dumpling.
Scumbag.
You already said that.
Bastard.
Oh, better be careful what you say, or people around here might think we like each other.
You can rot in hell for all I care.
Oh. I'm sorry for the disturbance, folks, but you got to admit, that's one special wacko chick.
You know, I have a grandmother that I'm sure was about the hottest thing on the planet. There was a time every Saturday night, and they dress up in tuxedos and gowns. And I'll go down to our pavilion at Two Moon Junction and dance all night long.
Two Moon Junction?
Yeah. That's my favorite place in all the world. My great-great-granddaddy was a pirate, you know.
No.
Really? Yeah, he and Lafitte and a bunch of the others got very pissed off at the slave traders and started raiding their ships and setting all the slaves free in South America. My grandmother says it was because they had this dream of America being the last bastion of freedom. But then they realized the problem was bigger than they were, and they really couldn't do anything about it. So they settled on the land and started raising cotton.
And put the slaves to work on the plantation.
My grandmother says he did it because he finally came to understand there would never be heaven on earth. For as long as the earth turns, there's always going to be corruption. Nothing was ever going to be perfect.
What you mean to say is that there was more money in cotton than in being a hero.
Something like that.
You're gonna make a hell of a lawyer, sweetheart.
I expect to live a double life. Maybe even a triple one if I get lucky.
Yeah, I thought you were just another tight-ass princess.
Like a princess.
You talk like a princess.
And you definitely have a tight ass.
was gonna call him Tom, too, but I figured he needed his own identity.
It's beautiful.
I was thinking about giving you one for your wedding present, but then I figured it'd be kind of hard for you to explain.
My cousins and I used to come here all the time when we were kids. It was our place. We did everything together. In the summertime, we used to sneak around at night and watch our parents making love. Then we'd come in here, strip down, touch each other all over. And one night after a party, they both got crazy drunk, took their father's Lincoln Continental and crashed it into a telephone pole. Timothy, the one who was driving, lived. But Charles died. 2 months later, Timmy put a gun to his head and shot himself out of despair. You remind me of that.